very important question, very good question we are discussing. Some people may be thinking that a GP, a sum of a GP should be applied, but it is not that GP's sum should not be applied over here. So what's the next method to evaluate this kind of limit? But I say you will have to use this formula to evaluate this limit, and that is a standard formula. So there are two methods to evaluate this. One is using that formula, and another is another means can be used L'Hopital rule or L'Hospital rule. So L'Hopital rule is mainly for competitive examination and for objective examination. But when you are appearing for a descriptive examination, then you cannot apply L'Hopital rule. So I will let you know what is L'Hopital rule at the end, but right now we are going through a systematic procedure to evaluate this. So what is that systematic procedure? X plus x square, x cube, up to x to the power n, and this n we can write like 1 plus 1 plus 1 up to how many times? Up to n times. So it is up to n times. Can we write like this? Yes, of course. Suppose you have 500 rupees, so you can split 500 rupees in 500 parts by writing 1 plus 1 plus 1 how many times? 500 times, because you are having 500. And suppose if you are having n rupees, so you can split like this. And in this case, in this particular case, n is what? N is a natural number, not real, it's a natural number. That is why it can be written like this. For example, suppose if you have n is 2/3, so you cannot write like 1 plus 1 plus 1 up to 2/3 times. So n is a natural number, and denominator is x minus 1. Okay, now let's see this first bracket in numerator, how many terms does it have? It is having n terms. How did we come to know? By the power is 1 2 3, starting from 1 and ending at n. So it contains n terms, and similarly here we are having n1. So we can write this as limit x tends to 1 x minus 1 plus x square minus 1, taking all minus all ones with all these terms, plus x square my x cube minus 1 plus up to x to the power n minus 1 upon x minus 1, all the terms in denominator having x minus 1. Now should we need to apply, means should we apply a formula for a square minus b square, a cube minus b cube? No, not at all, because after going x cube minus 1, you are having next term x to the power 4 minus 1, then x to the power 5 minus 1, and so on. So need not to apply formula for all these terms. So just write x minus 1 upon x minus 1, separating denominator. X square minus 1 can be written as x square minus 1 square, taking advantage of this step, plus x cube minus 1 can be written as 1 cube, x minus 1, and at the last we have x to the power n minus 1 to the power n upon x minus 1. And now we can apply that formula. Not though that formula means not a square minus b square, a cube minus b cube, but this standard limit must be applied. So let's see how this can be applied. X minus 1 will cancel each other, so the outcome will be what? 1 plus, here you can see the power is what? It is 2, and a is 1, so it is 2 into 1 to the power 2 minus 1. Similarly here power is, means n is what? 3. A is what? 1. So this is 3 into 1 to the power 3 minus 1, and same at this step n into 1 to the power n minus 1. So the first term is what? The first term is 1, second is 2, third is 3, up to what? N. You are you means realizing that this has become an AP whose sum is what? Whose sum is number of terms upon 2, number of terms upon 2 into first term plus last term, 1 plus n. This is sum of an AP, sum of an AP, or sometimes you say this is what? This is sigma n whose value is the same, n by 2 into 1 plus n. Hope you enjoyed its solution in the systematic way. Let's discuss now about L'Hopital rule. So what is L'Hopital rule or L'Hopital rule or L'Hopital rule? All are same. So L'Hopital rule says limit x tends to 1, x plus square, x cube plus up to x to the power n minus n upon x minus 1. First of all, put x is equal to 1 in numerator as well as in denominator. So it becomes 1 plus 1 square is 1, 1 cube is 1, and up to 1 to the power n, all are same, minus n upon 1 minus 1. 1 plus 1 plus 1, how many times? N times, which is n. N minus n will be 0 upon 0. So whenever you have 0 upon 0, then only you can apply L'Hopital rule, L'Hopital rule, or L'Hopital rule. And what is that rule? Rule says whenever you find 0 by 0, after substituting limit directly, just differentiate the numerator as well as the denominator separately. Means don't apply quotient formula, just differentiate numerator with respect to what? With respect to this x. So what is this? 1, derivative of x square is 2x, with respect to x its derivative 3x square, up to its derivative is nx to the power n minus 1, minus n being constant, its derivative is what? Derivative is 0, and in denominator you can see its derivative is 1 minus 0, which is 1. And limit x approaches to what? It approaches to 1. So we need to put x is equal to 1 here. So 1 plus 2 into 1 plus 3 into 1 square plus n into 1 to the power n minus 1. 1 to the power 3, 1 to the power 2, 1 to the power n minus 1, all are 1. So it becomes 1 plus 2 into 1, because it is 1, 2 into 1 is 2, 3 into 1 square is 3, plus dash 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 n into 1 to the power n minus 1 is n. And what is this? This is an AP whose sum is what? As I told you, number of terms upon 2, first term plus last term. So this is the miracle, and this is the concept of L'Hopital rule which we can apply. But this works for objective examinations, not for descriptive examination. Okay.